Imagine if we treated Cocker Spaniels how we treat greyhounds.
Food for thought. Question on Tumblr here is, my dad molested me, should I forgive him? Here's reality, we can't choose our parents. We can't choose our past. What we can choose is how we feel about the past, or what we focus on today in the present. Probably the biggest problem people have with their parents is thinking they shouldn't have any problems with their parents. If you got parents, you got problems. Even if you got foster parents, you got problems. If you got kids, you got problems. If you're alive, you got problems. Anytime you have problems is when you're dead, and that's why often people commit suicide or whatever, because they just can't handle the problems that life brings along. So what happens to us is how we deal with it that counts. So if someone's dad molested them, what should they do? In my opinion, this is my opinion here, I would say that you just got to move on. I would say forgive, because to hold on to that or to be a victim or to really have that as part of your identity every day, you know, my dad molested me. Yeah, it's not good, man. No one wants that. But it's happened. And it doesn't make it excusable. But also, why are we going to waste our lifetime reliving that every day or every time we have intimacy with someone that we care about or attracted to or whatever? And we're going to play that update. No, hey, we're not going to play the update. We need to update. We get our phones. We update our phones all the time. But we run these programs, these apps in our head that happened maybe in 1982 or 1996 or whatever. We run these apps in our head. It's time to fucking hit the update button, man. We update our phones with the latest fucking apps. Why the fuck don't we update our brain with what's going on right now? Would you get like a Samsung or if iPhone 7 or whatever, and then run the, like, ring up Apple Store or whatever and go, I want the apps from, like, 2008. Like, I'm gonna be like, why? Like, the new apps are better. They're smoother, they're faster, they're more productive. Why are we gonna be living in the past? Your dad molested you, it's not cool, but it's like, it's done, it's dusted, you can't change that. All you can change is how you feel about that. So I would say, understand that some people do some crazy shit. They're either on drugs, they've got mental issues, they're in a psychosis. Maybe they were molested, and that's just their way of dealing with how they were molested, is to molest someone else. Again, it doesn't excuse that behavior. But let's just not hold on to the rest of our life. Let's not have that become our identity, and we walk every step with heavy emotional baggage. Let's just relax with that and move forward and update your apps in your head. Your dad molested you, what should you do? I would say forgive. You have to forget. But let's focus on what matters, and that's the moment, man. You can't change the past. You can't change your parents. Maybe then one day someone will create an app for that. Until then, live in the present moment. The power of now. It sounds fucking corny. It sounds cashew cheesy, but it's really a reality. What you focus on is how you feel. What's your biggest problem right now? You see, it's not that big at all. And when I say now, I mean like right now. Like, what's my biggest problem right now sitting here in this living, what's my biggest problem right now? What's your biggest problem right now where you sit? You probably think, I have to look at you, you're a fucking ugly mug, dear writer. Seriously, what's your biggest problem right now? Not like in 5 minutes time or yesterday or tonight or tomorrow or next semester. Like right now, what's your biggest problem? See what I'm getting at? When you live in the moment, that's where the magic is, man. Can't choose the past, can't choose your parents. Can't control the problems you're going to have in life. What you can control is how you're going to see those problems, how you're going to react to these things, and how you're going to act in the future and the moments. We update our phones. Why aren't we updating our brains every single day?